Yeah. Okay. Good evening one more time. And yeah, all of us, we are in the evening. So good evening, everybody, and welcome to let's talk about Mantra. And this is the second episode of the event. And thank you guys, you are already that was here last week, rather. And I know that your time was never erased last week. So tonight again, we're going to be looking into some important information that will help you alongside to understand these projects well. And let's try to. Okay. Let's talk about this. So I'm going to start with the. I'm starting with. Let me just say an overview of. The definition of what uptrend, I mean what Mantra is, and give you a clear picture of this project, and it will also help some of you that just training for the first time, that means the last week episode. Okay, right. From what I pen down here, Mantra Dao is a decentralized application that on real chain, a DeFi focused blockchain built on the substrate framework. And since real chain is built on substrate, it can connect to Polkadot and take advantage of Polkadot's interoperability features. Now, I know all these are English, and I'm going to be, I'm going to factorize all these in the simplest form so that we can understand what this means. And it's actually, Mantra takes decentralized finance innovation of financial network where users' voice, or let me say users' voices, everybody's voice are heard one step further. It means that this project gives everybody opportunity to communicate, to share their view, to add to the network, and is a user-based platform that allow everyone to that allow every voices of the members in the community to be heard. And by instant, what they do is to give a room to be able to reward those that are member of that platform or of that community. Okay, so you participate. If you participate in the maintenance of activities or whatever the Mantra is doing, you are entitled to be rewarded. Okay. So Mantra also solved the problem that most DeFi projects face. And what's majorly what DeFi projects are facing is engagement, user inability. They don't communicate with their users. What they do, if you look at, if you have the opportunity to link up with different several DeFi projects, you have a clear understanding that all what you do is to connect with them on maybe via the platform. When you do your, you hold their tokens and you do your transactions to really easily connect with the their team is a difficult thing for you. But you can just start discussion with those that are in the community. But the team, you don't have a free access, or you don't have that close access, easy access to get some information from them. Okay. So, but Mantra Dao is is being structured as a decentralized autonomous organization. And what I mean by decentralized autonomous organization is that users of the platform, they have direct contact with how the platform is operating, and they can share it on the Telegram, share with the council member, share with the core team, and they look at it and see how they can give their feedback as far as the information you are submitting can help them and also grow the platform. So in Mantra DAO cases, users gain voting power by staking OHM tokens. So what we mean by decentralized autonomous organization, like I said that it gives everyone a direct access to interact with the platform and submit whatsoever proposal you are proposing, the betterment of the platform. And you can only do that, like we discussed last week, you can only do that by becoming a member of the platform. And what position you to become a member is the token that you are holding, which is the OHM token. Okay. So apart from providing financial services that Mantra provides for their users, Mantra also give its users reward for assisting in system development. So I will be looking at how is Mantra trying to do that? When we say they give every of their users the opportunity to be able to contribute to the development of the platform, let's see how they try to do that. And that leads us to the council members, Mantra council members, as well as Uptrend, I mean, Mantra is concerned. We have five council members. We have John, Patrick, Muli, we have Willie Coquin, we have James Anderson, we have Rogigo, it's this one should be from Argentina, and we have Stephen. And these council members, they compose of various crypto experts. And I have mentioned their name. They are experienced crypto developers. I think most of them, their background is from the finance, and also they are entrepreneurs. So that means the knowledge, they have knowledge about finance, and also they have knowledge about being able to establish their business on their own. So if you are thinking of, you want to gain an understanding about how to create a project, or you are looking at, you want to stand on your own and you feel that you want to learn how to do that in a way that will be successful, those are the guys you can liaise with, and they are free to chat them up on the Telegram. They are on our Telegram group also, our African group, they are there, and also they are also on the official channel also, you can liaise with them. So like I said, they are finance and entrepreneurship full of knowledge. That's what they are experienced crypto developers. And the projects per se, which is Mantra that we are looking at, was developed by a leverage. You know, we are actually considering how Mantra give all their users an opportunity to be able to be active and also contribute to the growth, the development of the platform. So we said Mantra leverages the leverage on the knowledge and the wisdom of the crowd. The wisdom of the crowd. And this is to create a fully decentralized. So it's not that it's being focused on who are the leaders, who is leading the platform, who are the whale, who are the big guys there. No, that's not what Mantra DAO project is all about. Everybody has a stake on the platform, because it's a fully decentralized ecosystem with an aim to give financial control back to the people. Okay. And Mantra team decided to build a new financial protocol, which many DeFi projects are unable to create. And they were able to do that through community governance functions. And we'll be looking at the governance and give a clear understanding of how this community governance function being put together to benefit everyone. So, last week, Eddie was trying to ask about what is Mantra Dao? How did it come about the names? What does the mantra mean? What does the Dao mean? And from the names, or from the, let's try to separate them one after the other. So Dao is actually a decentralized autonomous organization. And I have explained that what that means to you earlier, to give every user a direct say in how the platform operates. Okay. So, Mantra don't no partiality. Okay. And it means that you can contribute, you can contribute. Everybody contributes to make the platform work perfectly. Okay. And, this will lead us to, the building and the architectural view of the platform. The architectural view of the platform. Now, you agree with me that last week I was trying to give you the understanding that Mantra DAO is not built on Ethereum blockchain. And I made you to understand that the focus is Mantra is being built on real chain. And from the architectural view that I listed down here, I was able to let you know that is a decentralized autonomous organization, which means Mantra DAO is a decentralized autonomous organization that is being built on parity. What I mean by parity, I will still explain that one. Parity substrate for the Polkadot ecosystem, which focus on staking and lending. Okay. When you say parity, portrait, which is the Polkadot. I give you the understanding of what the parity substrate means. I think in 2018, November to be precise, there is Gavin Wood is the founder of the Polkadot that we are talking about. So the guy look at the blockchain of the maximalisms. When you say maximalism, those are the people that that believe more in Bitcoin. You can't tell them any other thing except Bitcoin. Okay, they are so their belief is on Bitcoin. Okay, so they look at the blockchain and they discover that the industry is becoming too nationalistic, meaning that is like you can't connect to the blockchain. You can't bring out. You have a project and you want to use Bitcoin blockchain to run it, but it's not an easy thing for you to connect to it. So he look at it that if this is how the blockchain is, can't we sit down and look at how we can have a particular blockchain that will beat another? That will beat another and make all these maximalisms creating barrier to enter, and also even reducing the fund that the technologies can even try to say, oh, let me have a phone, let me try to create something and use this blockchain. But because they don't have easy flow, they don't have easy connection to the blockchain. So he sat down and come up with an introduction of Substrate, and which is the foundation of the Polkadot. So when you see Polkadot ecosystem online, when you read about it, you know that there are things that is being locked up into it that you need to bring up and get a clear picture of what this ecosystem is really all about. So it's a parachain aiming to act as a link between many different type of blockchains. Okay, we have, so that we can have a standalone. So there is a standalone blockchain that any blockchain can easily connect to and carry out their operations and carry out and their functions. Okay, so that is what Gavin would come out with. And this will lead, this will allow developers to build highly advanced blockchain that is being customized for any project. For any project, you can now easily can easily bring out anything and connect it to the Polkadot ecosystem and start operating. So for some of you that are electronic, that are electrical engineers or maybe electro, you understand electronic. You know, I think in our secondary school days or in university, we need to understand what a substrate is as a material which provide the substance, provide the surface of which something is being deposited upon. Or let me say inscribed on. You have something and you can write something on that thing. Or you can deposit something on that thing. Or like a biologist, we talk about a surface or material. Or a material on which an organism can live upon. We live on that thing, okay, and grow. So when we live on that thing, it can grow because it's living on that thing. So that thing that is living upon is what is called substrate. So Mantra and some other projects, they live on a particular protocol or they live on a particular chain to live and to be able to connect to other blockchains. So I think I've been able to explain what a parity substrate, which is Polkadot, is. Then let's look at the Mantra DAO features the features. Let's look at the features, because I think I've been able to explain the architectural view here. We have the decentralized autonomous organization, parity substrate, the staking and lending, community governance, which is the real function, or let me say the main focus of this project. And this last one that I'm talking about, this community governance, you can be part of this exercise by using the native token, the native token of the platform, which is the OM, Okay. So let's look at the features. So the features of Mantra DAO. So we have the first one here is multi-asset staking and lending platform. So the users can perform multiple times of transactions like savings, lending, and governance, as Mantra DAO provides cross-chain across to the other existing dev projects. Look at this diagram. If you look at this diagram very well, if you have access to the white paper, you will see this diagram. And this diagram just is showing you different blockchain, different projects that Mantra connect with. Okay, connect with. I think late last week, Mantra was able to release send a notification, or let me say a post revealing the validation and devalidation link that cover has released or has joined. You know, we connect to different projects, and we can only connect that different project easily, and they can network, they can send their token to Mantra DAO, and Mantra DAO can also easily communicate with them because of the chain on which the project is being built upon, which is real chain. Okay. As we continue, we understand more about real chain, because it is not Mantra DAO that is being built on Polkadot. Okay, it's not the Mantra DAO that is being built on Polkadot. Mantra DAO is being built on real chain, and the real chain itself is the one that is making use of the Polkadot ecosystem. Okay, and because Mantra is being built on that chain, it has all the features, it has everything that real chain has to operate, to also operate, because it's been built on that chain. Okay, so like I was saying, I've talked about the multi-asset staking and lending, that so we can lend, you can save, you can stake any token that is connected to Mantra. And all those things, you see Binance here, you see Cosmos here, you see Cava here, you see Compound, you see there are many. So we have them here. We have them here. And as the project continue to grow, develop, all these things will come in, and you will see them on the platform, on the app, on the Mantra app, that you can easily network. You see the Polkadot itself is here, and Polkadot has like three of their tokens. They have of their tokens. So it means that their tokens also is coming to Mantra platform, and you can easily do the transaction with them. So let's move to I'll explain to you the staking. So staking and lending. So in addition to the OHM that you can stake on our platform, the multi-asset, in addition to OHM, which is the platform token that you can stake on this platform, we have other Polkadot native assets like DOT, and as well as the Kasama is KSM tokens. Also you can stake that one also and also you see the Cardano, the Tezos, the US, the Tron, all those ones are works at the blockchain that Mantra is still going to connect with. And the lending platform for the project, Mantra is thinking of deploying three phases of lending capability. Okay. Sorry. So Mantra is planning, or according to white paper, has three lending capability phases to be deployed on this lending platform. And what are the phases? The first one will use cross-chain bridges to connect with already existing lending protocol like Compound. Okay, there are already existing dev lending protocol. Okay, we have Compound, we have Nexus. Oh, we have many of the lending platforms that are already existing. Okay, so Mantra DAO, the first of their phase, will lead many to connect to all these existing lending platforms, and they can do their transaction. You can lend, you can gain from them also. So those are the first one. That's the first one. And this will allow Mantra DAO users to access lending services from even the Ethereum-based assets, okay, that are proposed by their open source. So if They are open source protocol. Their source is open. If it's not closed, if their source is open, then you can easily get, can easily lend whatsoever you want to lend to, on, I mean, to the, the Ethereum based asset or to the lending services, sorry, the lending services. Okay. And then this will enable us to access third party lending. You understand? So it's a third party lending. You are not lending from the Mantra DAO. You are lending from the third party. So all these things was made, all these things is, can be easily accessed because of the chain where Mantra DAO is operating, And you can also even access stablecoin loan, you can collect loan from through these means. Okay, and let's see, the second phase of the Mantra lending phase, this will allow the users to be able to access third party. Okay, that one is third party. The first one I talked about is give Mantra DAO to access lending services from Ethereum based assets. Okay, so you can, if for example, if Uptrend is having, if Uptrend has a lending platform, so you can easily lend one up because it's an open source that is, that has access to easily connect to Mantra. And if it's another platform that is Ethereum based asset and has open source, you can easily connect and lend, and has a lending platform, so you can easily connect and get whatsoever you want to get. Okay, then the second phase that I have mentioned earlier is to connect to access third party lending services to use savings products or access stablecoin loan. And the third phase will deploy a unique lending algorithm that will function similar to Mark DAO. I don't know if many of you know about the Mark DAO. If you understand how his operation is, you will really definitely understand this. And it's more like a support, you support an asset for multiple blockchain to be used as collateral. Okay. Use them as a collateral. You stand, it's standing for you. Why? Because you have a stake, you have a part, you have a particular a stake with Mantra. So you can do whatsoever, you can borrow from them. And then, so that's for that. Let's look at the DAO, which is a decentralized autonomous organization. So you can only access this thing through the native token. User can gain excessive voting rights. You gain voting rights on important protocol decision. Like I mentioned last week, I said the token that you hold, the token that you stake, is the pass, is the ticket that make you to be a part in what is happening in Mantra DAO organization. So if you want to vote in a proposal, if somebody send a proposal and the proposal is open, you see the proposal, so for you to vote for it, you vote for it through what you are holding. So when you hold OM, one OM means one vote. When you hold two, it means two votes. When you hold three, it means three votes. So you can vote as many as possible based on the number of tokens that you are holding. Based on the token that you are holding. Then I've not talked about this, the merit-based staking reward system. Okay. Through Mantra incentive systems, user can gain reward for actively using the platform. So using the platform alone, you have reward that would follow. Okay. Like for those of you that are started staking, you're already getting reward for staking. There are other things that will come out, that will come up as Mantra is progressing and also growing alongside. And you can, when you are active and you engage, you definitely get reward. So there are merit-based staking reward system that is on ground for as many of us that want to pay into it, and is 88.8% we have. And recently we launched providing the liquidity. When you're providing the liquidity, you'll be able to get uni token as a reward. And all these features that Mantra is releasing, until when you try to engage, you understand proper, you understand what, how the platform is working. I have my legs than 1 minute, but if this thing cut me off, I was still going to create another link and send it to the Telegram so that you can join. Okay, so just sorry for the inconvenience. So the next one I'm talking about is the USDOM stablecoin. This is a stablecoin that I mentioned when I was trying to explain the lending platform. I said the lending platform has the three phases. So here, I'm going to continue now. I hope you can see the screen. I hope you can see the screen, everybody. You're not chatting. I want to see your chat so that I will know that you can see the screen. Okay. Right. I've opened a lot of things here, so let me just close them. It should be done. Okay. Alright. Okay, so I was talking about the stablecoin. So the stablecoin is going to be having link with the lending platform. So the lending platform, when the third phase is then released out, if the third phase is launched, that's when this stablecoin also is going to be released. So just watch out for the lending platform. So when the first phase is released and people can easily network with and people can easily connect with an existing lending protocol, which is the first phase. And the second phase, you discover that people can easily, they can access third-party lending service. So know that we are on our way to get the third phase being released out, and that one will also come together with the stablecoin. And then the next one that I'll be talking, and I think the stablecoin is going to be pegged on the dollar. It's going to be pegged on dollar. Just similar to DAI. DAI is the Mantra Dao. And you will see all, if you look at this picture very well, you will see all the plans. And I think I've been able to, we did set now, secondary school, we did set. The union center and the subset so these are sets. This is three sets. Yeah, and this is a union. The union. Assets, no. Alright, so like I said, the main difference between the stablecoin for Mantra and that of the Maka is that the collateral, what you are going to be using for DAI, is Ethereum based assets that you use as the collateral to get whatever you want to get. But for Mantra DAO users, to be able to use crypto assets multiple blockchain, okay, as the quadrilateral to do whatever you want to do. How will I put it now? You can use, because we have a connections of different projects, a connection of different lending projects to the platform. Now, if you now want to get this stablecoin, you can stake any of these tokens that have access to this platform. And by doing so, you'll be able to mine. Let me use mine. You'll be able to mine the stablecoin USDM. Meaning that what you stake on that third lending platform, what you stake can get you this stablecoin. Okay? So it's not necessarily means that you stake Ethereum-based asset only, as it's applicable to DAI, which is the marker. But you can stake any crypto assets from multiple blockchains, and you can use them as a collateral to get whatever you want to get. So the project really has a big dream. And don't be too early to draw a conclusion about the project, because it's still very young. So it's growing per day, growing every day. We come out with new innovations every day. So look at the next one is the Mantra pool. The reason why I'm bringing all these things to your understanding is so that you will know how big this project is, the potential that lies in the project that you have not really opened your eyes to. So that is why I'm sharing all these things with you. Let's look at the Mantra pool. This is just like a form of game. It's a game similar to some principle, similar in principle to the, I think, the popular Ethereum DApp pool together, that we already have the understanding of some DApps on Ethereum based on Ethereum blockchain. You see, when you open your Trust Wallet, you go through the browser, you see different apps, or you go to some of it that you use mToken. When you go to the browser, you see different apps, and some of it that you use Egin. When you go through the browser, you see different apps, and you can enter, you can play games and get some rewards. Some of it that you use EOS, and you have access to some of their apps. You have access to play games and get some reward there. So here, Mantra pool is like a game similar to the principle of the popular Ethereum dApps that you already have the knowledge of. So there are some key differences that you need to know. And in order to enter Mantra pool, what you need to do is to have a chance of winning a share of Mantra pool staking reward. So what you need to do to be partaker of this is to just know that you stake OM. So when you stake OM and you get a reward for staking, so users have to burn their OM token. So when you stake and you get a reward for staking, now I think I was trying to explain validators and miners. I was trying to explain it last week when the information was dropped on the Telegram. But I did not go deeper to give you a clear picture of how they work. You know, you remember I mentioned something sometimes that the Bitcoin that you send out, you can't reuse them. It's just once you use them. So the same thing is what is happening here. Every cryptocurrency or every crypto asset, they are used once. And when they use one, when you are trying to reuse them, technically, when you try to use them, technically, is wrong. But there are people that make use of them, because I think in last 3 years, when I was holding a token that was created by the team that I'm working for, I'm part of the core team that were working together, and we created a token. And the token is being used in order to do to help both your blog, and you get reward for upvoting. So like me now, as a psalmist, I have the power that people want to plug into. So for them to have access, and not for them to rush that asset, so that I will not kill the power. So we need to set up a token that people will buy from, and they use that token to access my power and get vote for it. Okay. So, and the token that they sent to me is supposed not to be reused. The token is supposed to be burned. Because if I'm reusing it, it means that the money that they used to purchase that token, I am now selling it back to them again to buy and buy and buy and buy. So, and I still have a pool of this token in my wallet sitting down. And the one that they are even sending to me again, I'm still reselling it back to them. So technically it's wrong. So what you need to do is to burn them. And as you are burning those tokens, the value of that token will come up. So that's what I'm trying to explain here, that for Matrax staking reward, the people, what you stake, generate a reward. Okay? And that staking, what you have in that staking pool, supposed to be born to increase the power, to increase the value of OM. Okay? So, and I said, an alternative way to enter Mantra pool is to enter it automatically. And the only way by you to enter it automatically is by staking. When you stake, you're already in that pool. You're already in that pool. But if you don't stake, you hold the tokens in your wallet doing nothing, you have not really entered into that pool of Mantra, the game that we are talking about. Okay. All right. Don't worry. You will still understand it as we proceed. And when the platform is released, I can do the practical explanations for you to capture what I'm actually saying. So the last one here I'm talking about is the Karma Protocol Reputation. Karma Protocol Reputation System. As mentioned previously, Karma Protocol is just like a reputation system developed for a Mantra DAO ecosystem. This unique system is just to provide special perks for users who make positive contributions towards the project. Or let me put it this way, simply use the platform actively. So there is a forum, or let me say there is a platform whereby people contribute, give suggestions, submit proposals. So your contributions, when you give contributions in that forum, in that platform, so the protocol is more like, for some of us that are here, almost everybody that are here are part of Uptrend platform. So your contribution on Uptrend platform increase your reward, and at the same time increase your level. Okay, increase how people knows you. Increase how people can say, I know this person. This person has been contributing. So the same thing applicable in Mantra DAO. On that forum, when you contribute, you submit proposal, people vote on your proposals. Now, Karma Protocol is a reputation system. It builds up your reputation, and your reputation grew on the forum, on the platform. It gives you access, it gives you opportunity to have an easy access to access lending, to access loan on the platform when the lending platform is released. So every features of Mantra won't lead to another, but what is more important thing is your staking. So get the understanding theoretically. When the practical comes to be, we quickly catch it up and say, oh, this is what Samus is saying. This is what this man is saying. This is what he's saying. You quickly understand the information perfectly. So like I said, your participation on the Mantra pool that I mentioned earlier, your participation on the staking, your participation on the forum, the contribution you give on the forum or the proposal you submit, then you invite your friend to Mantra Dao platform. Because I'm still studying because this guy still studying the platform. So when you invite your friends to the platform, people see, they see you that, okay, this guy is doing something. You build your reputation. Some of you that are on Twitter, they are on Uptrend, you are on different platforms. What are the things that you have been doing to assist this platform to grow, to bring more people into the platform? Yes, Africa is growing gradually as decentralized finance is increased. But have you been able to at least invite your friends and guy, come? Or have you tweeted something about this project and say, guy? Because when you tweet and you tag Mantra, they see, they like, sometimes they retweet, they comment. All these things is positioning you high in the face of the council members, in the face of the people that belongs to the that are already a member. You understand? So whatever you are doing on this, as this project grows, counts for you. As you attend this project, as you attend this event, there is a record for the people that attended last week. There is a record for those that attend this week. So as you proceed to enjoy or to participate in whatever we are doing, is actually increasing your reputation as well as Mantra is concerned. So without having karma benefits, include what you get from this protocol of reputation that we're talking about, is you benefit better staking reward. So if a normal person that just take tokens and didn't contribute to anything, didn't do any contribution, didn't render any contribution, is getting 88.8% on his staking, you can be getting like 120, you can be getting as much as percentage you want to get, because your Kamal protocol reputation, the reputation you have with the platform, is increasing. So the more you increase your reputation, the more you get more speaking reward. And with that, we move to almost the last, but not the least, on how Mantra DAO works. And I've been able to give a clear information about how this project works. So I've explained staking and lending. I've explained staking and lending. Users have to stake their tokens. You have to stake your dots. Dot is the token for poker dots. So when this is released, when this is, we already have them on the platform, you can stake them on this, our staking platform, and you get OM for, as a reward for staking it. Okay. And again, I said that users have the option to, you have different options to use different tokens for collateral when the lending platform is released. Then ownership and governance. Ownership and governance. How it works is the holders, like I said, I said, what makes you to be part of this platform is the OM. So all these three things that I listed here, all the staking, the lending, the governance, the reputation, all of them point direct to the whole token. So the ownership and governance, this means that any important changes or parameters that the platform wants to implement on the platform, you have a right to vote or to unvote. You have a right to vote or to unvote if you are holding the token. So you are the decision maker. you are the decision maker, and the reputation side of it, I've explained it. Mantra implement a reward system named Karma Protocol. And this is designed to recognize your contribution of the contribution on the platform as a holder, as OM holder, taking, and then in the platform by providing you, to give you the reputation point. So there is a reputation point you get as you contribute to the growth of the platform. Okay, I think that's end tonight's information. And there is a time for question and answer. And I see one question. What type of proposal? Okay, let me give you an example. Example is, I will use what many of you are familiar with, which is the platform you are writing from, Uptrend. Now, as Uptrend platform, there are some of posts I have come about. I think I saw some of the posts written by some of you guys trying to give an advice or try to recommend some things on the platform. You recommend that this blah 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 to be included, or this to be removed, or this, you write it out as an article, you send it out, and what you get as a reward is or votes or comments, or or Jeff himself was able to capture the thing and said, this is what we need to work, and they take that to the team. They discuss it out. They look at it. Is it okay? If within that organization or within that team, they were able to come to a conclusion that this idea is good and is good to go, and they implement it, what's your reward? No reward. Even if you are saying it to some of your friends and say, I was the one that implemented that. Send that information. I was the one that come and see my article. Come and see. We can see the article. But the reward you can get is output. Nothing more. And comment. And thank you. Okay. And they will implement it. And the member of the platform will see that, they have changed this thing. They have changed this thing. And they might not even mention it that it was you that suggested it. All right. But in Mantra DAO, because it's a fully decentralized platform or community, when you suggest something, you write it as a proposal. When you write it as a proposal on the platform, people within the community that already have a token that is being staked, they vote on it. They vote on that proposal, and when that proposal is being approved and being implemented, you get a reward from the community. You get reward for implementing that proposal, and it will be stated. They will see, everybody, the whole community will know that you are the one that implemented that. You are the one that initiated that proposal. So is more like an open field for everybody to feed on and plant something that can last for long. I think I've been able to explain that. So if you have a question, please, you can drop them, and if you want to come on voice, you can also raise your hand. I will call you, and I'll call you, then you can speak on the. Okay. If I lend my token to the third party, what is the reward? More. Didn't get that one. What is the reward? If I can get that question correctly, you are asking that if you lend your token to a third party, what's your reward? Now, like I said earlier, the lending platform they are still working on, but based on a white paper. What is being written down in white paper when you give your whatsoever you are giving out, the reward you get back, you get your reward back in OM. Okay, you get your reward back in OM. And we are still going to be looking at all those platforms one after the other, and I am looking at even the founder or one of the council member also will be here in our subsequent meetings to also enlighten us on this platform, each platform. Well, you know, I'm giving support. So there are limits to questions I can answer, but I can still give you a clear picture of the how it will look like, and then how the lending platform will benefit everyone. Okay, I think I've been able to. Let me look at does all the third party has different rules set aside for those who want to lend, or the rules remain same among the integrated platform? Yeah, this is it. You know, like I said, every other blockchains or every other lending platform, they have their rules. What Mantra is just doing is to provide a link to fetch or to connect with their existing lending platform. Okay, so whatever rules they have is with them, okay, and it's going to be the same line, is what our the same, how will I put it now, the same rule that governs their platform is the same thing that is going to come alongside to the Mantra platform, because you are not changing their rules, you are not changing anything, you are just connecting, you are just gaining an access to their platform. Okay, I think I've been able to answer that one. It's just like a plug and play. Okay.
Yeah, there is a question here pointing towards lending. So I'm going to, let me just give a clear picture of how lending works in the DeFi ecosystem in general, so that we'll be able to understand the process. Okay, so let me try to explain that. Like I shared initially, I was able to explain that Mantra has three phases, and when you are lending, you lend the token in order to get a reward. Okay, and let's take for example, you are lending OM. And because OM has a connection, a link, not only on Ethereum-based assets like Compound used to, give you access to be able to have assets, user access to lending interest from Ethereum-based assets. So that's the first opportunity that Mantra give to their users that are providing that are lending on the platform. And going further on the phase two of the lending program, the project is able to give you access to connect to the third party, in which you have access to get as high interest on your savings, and it will propel you to be able to receive a reward from all the from the third party lending service providers. So lending program is more like you have like 1,000 ohm, and you are looking at in the next 2 or 3 months it may increase, or you are looking at the amount you use to buy it, and there is a drop in the price, and you don't want to sell it, and you need money. So you are not looking at it of you're looking at it as you want to lend the platform in order to get the required amount of money you wanted. So you lend the 1,000 to the platform, or to the lending platform, okay? And then you request for the amount of whatever you wanted, and by the time you are done with the that means the 1,000 has served as a collateral to get the required amount of money that you needed, okay? And then because OM has a connection with different blockchains, so it's not a determinant of the liquidity you provided that determines the amount of the assets you get, because OM has a link, or let me say he has you have an opportunity to get assets that are linked with the Polkadot assets, because OM, or let me say the stablecoin, I don't want to go to stablecoin of the Mantra, is backed up by every Polkadot asset. Okay. So if OM is being backed up, or let me say the stablecoin of OM, or the stablecoin of Mantra is being backed up by Polkadot assets, or the Polkadot assets, it means that when you give that stablecoin as a collateral, you have access to get reward from any of these tokens, depend on the liquidity you are providing. So I have third question here. I have a question here, and the question is pointing towards the stable coin. It's pointing towards the stable coin, stable coin, which is the US DOM stable coin. So it's still pointing towards it. And the individual is actually asking if it is going to be released 2021. What are the incentives and the rights? Well, before I need to explain, let's try to look at roadmap again. Give me some few minutes. Let me share this with you so that you can be able to get that clearly. So when you look at this, you will discover that this is actually coming, is going to come out in 2020, which point to the launch of the third phase of the lending platform. The lending platform is going to now give the, is going to come together with the release of the stablecoin, and the stablecoin is actually the US DOM is multi quadrilateral, and knowing that is pegged on dollar, is still multi quadrilateral, meaning that like DAI, which is the Mantra DAO asset, is only using ERC20 asset to back it. Okay, but for the Mantra stablecoin, it is going to be backed up by any cryptocurrency. Okay, that supports what are supported by the Polkadot network. Okay, and those assets are like the OHM, DOT, TSM, BTC, Ethereum, and ERC tokens. Even we still have US, we have ADA, we have Tezos. So the specific assets that are used in practice will depend on the liquidity of the underlying assets. Okay, so it is what you select, you as a
what are going to get. So it is what you get. Okay, so that's the understanding of the stablecoin.
Okay, another question I see here is pointing towards the direction of staking, the minimum amount of staking OHM. Okay, I'm going to be sharing this one now. Let me see how I can open the. I'm going to open the. Let me open the app. Where is it? Let me open the app. Should be here. Let me open the app so that we can see how the staking platform look like. Yeah, so that but the minimum you can the minimum amount of OM you can stake is actually you can stake as low as one. Well, you can stake coins. So look at this account here. This account here presently has 0.2 OM, and the account already stake 114. That's like 7.7 US dollar, and it has staked for just 10 days. And it has earned 2.4 within that 10 days. And so if you are looking at, you want to stake, now because this account already has a staking running, so that is why you have claim and stake. So now for me now to stake, if you are new, you will see stake, you still staking column around here. And when you click the staking, this is the page is supposed to display for you if you are starting your staking. So you already have your OM being in your wallet. Your OM is already in your wallet, which is going to be displayed here. And the what is displayed here is not going to be the one that you're going to see here also. So there's going to be zero OM here because we are not staking. Here is a new account. Okay. So if it is a new account, I just want to start staking. So here you enter the amount of the OM you want to stake. Like I said, you can't stake decimal. You can only stake whole number. So let me type one. So I can stake one. And stake one, which is the minimum. So if I can stake one, so you are going to click next. So immediately you click your next, it's going to open. It's going to tell you to stake. So, and immediately you click your stake, or before you click your stake, sorry, before you click your, let me close this. Now, before you click your stake, okay, before you click your stake that I clicked earlier, it's going to show you a column. Let me reload this so that's for clear understanding. Let me reload. Okay. So, and don't forget, you already have your MetaMask extension being installed and imported your Ethereum wallet. Okay, so you click stake because I'm staking more. I already have a stake. That is why it's showing staking stake more. So it's supposed to be stake. So you click stake. here, this is the page is going to display for you when you are staking. And here is going to display zero and no day here, and nothing also will be displayed here. Okay. So when you now type, let's say you type one to stake one. Now under it, you will have the amount of the days you want to stake that your token. So you are the one to impute the day that you want to stake. So you can impute as many days you know that you can withstand. So the more when you insert your or impute the date, then you click next and it take you down here. Take you down here, then you stake. And when you click your stake, it's going to connect to your MetaMask. Okay, when you connect your MetaMask to display for you,
the amount of the gas
and your weight around this. So you click, you confirm. The moment you confirm, and then proceed, then they give you a place where you can now click stake. Okay, stake, and you are done with your staking. Okay, I think I've been able to explain that. So like I have said earlier, you are the one to so what you do is the account is already in a staking pool. That is why you have on claim reward, claim now, supposed to just show you stake. Okay, so that's just the process you follow when you want to stake your OM token. Okay, and as time goes on, more assets will come here. We already have three assets. We have Uni OM, and we have this is the token for real chain, and we have OM. So more will still come in as we continue to grow the platform. And so these are the other features we have. This is loan, this is lending, this is governance, this is Mantra pool, and this is karma, just like I have explained earlier. And this is swap. You can swap your token just like all what you are dealing in a unit swap. So all these things are, and it's like a wallet. So all these things are here. You see here, we are be effective and functional when everything are in place. Yeah, okay. Thank you guys for, I think I've been able to explain that. So, and I give clear understanding on your questions. So now I think there are no more questions. So like we normally do, I will need to just drop you a questionnaire. Whenever you answer just 5 questions. The way you, and as we normally do, the first 5 questions, I mean the first 5 that answer the question correctly go home with 10 OM each, and which will be shared at the end of the month of every month. So there is pool of 200 OM for a whole month, and then it's been spread within the 4 weeks. So I enjoy you guys to always be part of. So I'm going to be dropping the link now. Where's the link? Okay. So I've dropped the link for you to see, so you can go ahead and solve the question. That's how it's coming again. Well, it's a simple question. You can just read and understand and drop them and submit rather.
So while doing that, let me just give a vote of thanks. I thank you all for coming. It's a weekly program, so we see next week Monday. And please make sure that you also invite your friends. Let them also enjoy this information as we grow together in the area of decentralized system. We should be able to also invite our friend to be also a beneficiary in what we are sharing every week. So, and also try to tweet about this event, what you have learned, and make sure you tag Mantra Dao, and share your view, share your understanding about what you have learned. And also, let's join the Telegram group if you are not yet there, and interact, engage, and your engage is always count. It's always count. Ask questions, and we would love to answer your questions. All the council members are on the Telegram, Africa Telegram. So let's keep on doing our best to invite our friends. So thank you for coming, and see you next week. And until then, I love you all.